It seems the Coke is having some second thoughts about going woke. Now, one question is, how do these companies like Coca-Cola, like Delta, how do they go woke in the first place? We sometimes think it's purely a decision by the CEO or decided by senior management, but I don't think so. I think what's happened is that we have seen an energized left, particularly among younger people. These are people who have come out of colleges and universities, let's just say over the last 10 to 15 years. And these are people who have been mobilized in resistance to Trump and Trumpism. And so what they are determined to do is to pressure their employers from within to become instruments of leftist activism. We see this in the publishing industry, where suddenly conservatives have a hard time publishing in mainstream publishing, not because there aren't sympathetic editors who want to do it, but because there's this kind of woke coalition that threatens to walk out and quit and refuse to show up at work. And so they're pressuring management from within. I bet you something like this has been happening at Coke, and especially at Coke. Why? Because, you know, the head of Coke, this guy, CEO James Quincy, he's the British guy. I mean, he's probably sitting in, you know, it's at having at the Savoy Hotel in London, and he's probably, you know, eating finger sandwiches, cucumber sandwiches, and tea, and he's probably thinking, what is this bloody nonsense going on in America? I have to say all kinds of stupid things. But, you know, but he's doing it because he's obliged to do it. But I don't really know if he wants to, But nevertheless, Coke really decided to go woke. Probably over the objections of James Quincy. Those Yankees are bloody cracked. But nevertheless, he's playing along. That's his job. And so what did Coke do? They have, first of all, they got involved with this Facebook and Instagram campaign to get Donald Trump deplatformed. They also started a massive diversity program in which they would only do business if you had like 30% minority ownership. They took it to such an extent that they hired this guy, Bradley Gayton, a kind of a left-wing fanatic. And this guy established a plan in which Coke would not do business with law firms unless the law firms were, quote, diverse. They had to have at least half of their attorneys be black. So this is carrying the diversity issue to kind of an insane level. And then finally, Coke jumps right into the Georgia voter integrity campaign, issues a statement in which, again, this is James Quincy, which was a statement that basically said that he was totally opposed to the Georgia law. He wanted to speak unequivocally against it. And so this was Coke really behaving as if it were, you know, some kind of a left-wing lobbying outfit and not a mainstream global company. Now, very recently, two remarkable developments have occurred at Coke. First, Coke has issued a new statement, which is very different in tone. We now believe the best way to make progress is for everyone to come together and listen, respectfully share concerns, and collaborate on a path forward. We remain open to productive conversations. It's time to find common ground. In the end, we all want the same thing. Free and fair elections, the cornerstone of our democracy. Now, this kind of statement is anathema to the left. They would never go with it. And so, I'm sure there was vociferous objections, particularly by this kook Bradley Gayton. And so Coke basically goes, Bradley Gayton, it's time to say bye-bye. And so Coke essentially terminated this Bradley Gayton character. He had a big fat package, so he's going to be fine. He's going to sort of sail off in his yacht. But nevertheless, he's been taken off the job, you might say. And the new person who's come in his place has suspended the diversity program. A statement that she made was, she said, basically, we're going to, quote, reevaluate all this stuff. I think Coke has basically realized that, number one, they're in a state, Georgia, that although it now has two Democratic senators, it's a red state. And it has a state legislature that doesn't take kindly to this kind of political activism, that in fact is willing to penalize Coke, even on all kinds of tax breaks that have been given to Coke, if Coke wants to keep this up. And then as a major company, why would you want to antagonize half the country? Why would you want to turn off a lot of people, some of whom presumably drink Coke? I'm not really sure why, but nevertheless they do, and they like it. And so Coke has potential customers. Do you want to take your base of 330 million Americans and to cut it down to 150 right off the top? I mean, what could be dumber? And I'm sure at some level, James Quincy sort of knows that. This is really dumb. But, you know, my American kooks are making me do it. But he's had enough. And I think his team has had enough. And so Coke has made a collective decision to kind of pull back from being woke. And I think that's a welcome development. It means that this is not a done deal. We conservatives don't just have to bemoan these developments. It shows also that we need to counter the woke activism within companies that we're part of. Why? To neutralize the pressure that's coming from the other side. And in this way, Coke can provide a kind of sobering example of the painful costs, political, but also economic, if you as Coke decide to go woke.